Hi. So probably you are seeing this now because you qualify academically. Now it's time to discuss finance. Finance is very important, and with us, we have four places that we can help you with. This is Germany, Netherlands, Denmark, and Spain. And you have to listen to this finance carefully because any budget that we have here is exactly what we can help you with. So you have an ideology. When you listen to the budgets across board, you take a pen and paper, convert by the ongoing rate in your country, if you don't have euros directly, then you'll be able to have a very specific idea. When you now choose an option, we can now discuss based on this option. So please get a pen, paper, calculator by your side. You can press pause on this many times so that you can be able to go over it and over it so that you'll be able to understand the finances involved. Now, these prices are after all discounts and everything. So these are the raw prices that you have to get. So you have to pay attention to the finance because as you qualify academically, you need to qualify financially to make it happen for you. We want to make you to make an informed decision. So it's always better you know what you're getting involved in before you proceed. Now, I'm going to read some options out for you because these are specific numbers. So the first option now is through Spain. You have heard through the EBBA, that's the Executive Bachelor's Program. And you can, after the bachelor's program, you can go and do a master's. So the bachelor's program and master's program are together. It's like, in total, you have to do it like 2.5 years. But you cannot just finish your bachelor's and say you want to stop halfway. It goes together. So you have to complete it together. So in all, this will cost, it depends on what your specialization is. Some specializations cost as up to 33,000 euros and above. Some cost about 13,000 euros and above. That's when you now add the other bachelor's program with it, it will come to about 26,000 and above. So take it that you need 26 to 33,000 to study an executive bachelor's program in Spain. But across board, the initial deposit will be from like 7,600 euros and above initial deposits. When you get on campus, you pay the rest over time. Then you're supposed to show a bank statement of 12,000 euros. So again, you need between 26 to 30, what, 3,000 and above. Then out of this expense, it depends on your specialization, like I said. You can drop 7,600 euros initially to travel. Then you need 12,000 euros bank statement. So to travel out of where you are now, you need at least 7,600 euros and above and a bank statement of 12,000 euros. Now, the other option is coming for a pure bachelor's degree in Spain. So in all, school fees will be around 13,000 euros per year. And some programs are 3.5 years, some are 3 years. You can pay what? 7,600 euros as your initial deposit. Then you can also pay what? 12,000 euros bank statement. Just show the bank statement. Bank statement is enough. So you need 7,600 and 12,000 for the bachelor's program. Now, if you're coming for an MSc or an MBA, depending on the school, it's about 20,000 euros and above for the school fees. But you can pay 8,000, 8,009 and above for your school fees as the initial deposit. Then you need 12,000 euros bank statement. You see, I keep repeating this 12,000 euros bank statement because that's the minimum bank statement requirement for you to study in Spain. So for an MSc or MBA, you need 20,000 and above depending on the school. But initially, you need to drop around 8,009 cash to the school as initial deposit, then 12,000 euros bank statement. Now, Masters of Arts, depending on the school, it's about 13,000 euros and above, depending on the school, in total for your whole program. And what you can drop as low as 6,600 euros self to the school. When you get on campus, you pay the rest of our time. They'll give you an instrumental payment. Then you need 12,000 euros bank statement as usual. So Spain, anything I said, initial deposits, you can drop that certain amount when you get on campus. You pay the rest of our time because they'll give you a payment plan. then you need 12,000 euros bank statements. The visa process is about 2.5 months, so it's quick. Then you have a 1 year post study visa across board. Denmark, fantastic place. Now, for now, we only have top up degrees in informatics related courses or marketing related courses. So if you have a business background, or you're somebody that is interested in having a top up in computer science based on you have a computer science background, also is possible. So the top ups, they range from 10 to 13,000 euros depending on the school. Then you pay everything at once for the school fees. That's the difference. You understand? That's the difference with Denmark. You need the whole deposit at once. So if they say 10,000, you pay at once. If it's 13,000, you pay at once. Then the bank statement. This is very tricky. A lot of times they don't ask for the bank statement. So at the end of the day, the cash involved is about 13K euros. Let's just say 10 to 13K, depending on the school. Same thing with an MBA or an MSc. You just pay 13K on an average for your school, 13,000 euros, just multiply it. At once you pay, they might not ask you for a bank statement. If they ask you, maximum is around maybe 10,000 euros to 13,000 euros, depending on the school, just like the school fees. But majority of time, they don't ask for the bank statement. So your cash involved in Denmark is what? Majorly the school fees, and that's why it's going to be paid at once. So you as a person now, you have to consider that. So you say it's upfront, that's upfront. Now the good thing is that you can bring your family members along with you when you're going, if you have your kid with you and everything. But you need extra bank statement of 10,000 euros for each child that is traveling. So that's the difference. Now the Netherlands, and sorry, back to Denmark. The visa process is about 2.5 months, just like Spain too. So, and you have a post-study visa for 6 months, as usual. So you're allowed to stay back to look for a job. When you find a job in Denmark or neighboring countries, you stay back. So you can always look for a job in the Schengen job, but majorly you can stay in Denmark, depending on your profession. So that's why I don't allow everybody to go to Denmark. It really depends on where you're coming to study. Now, Netherlands. Netherlands now, you need about, for the bachelor's program, you need about 13,000 euros and above. You pay everything at once for the first year. But the bachelor's program, the good thing is that the school fees drops back down to 8,900 per annum for the second year. But the first year, you need to pay the whole 13,000 euros and above, depending on this thing for the bachelor's program. And you show a bank statement of 11,000 euros. So that's basically it for the bachelor's program. And you have a wide range of courses that you can go for. For master's degree, that's the master's degree. Now, you have courses that are about 19,000 euros and above, but you can pay 15. When you get on campus, you pay the rest of our time. Then you need 11,000 euros bank statement. That bank statement has to come from your sponsor or you. It's fine. Now, the visa process is about 3 months, 2.5 months to 3 months, depending on the intake you're going for, a good number of intakes per year. Now, if you go back, the difference is with Netherlands, it's very, very, the formal education is very good, and the payment is almost like 80%, you understand, that you have to deal with. So at the end of the day, it's important that you make upfront deposit, then you just show bank statements. Now, last but not least, we have different options for Germany. Now, the bachelor's program, you can find bachelor's as cheap as 7,000 euros. You can pay an initial deposit of 2,000 euros. When you get on campus, you pay the rest over time. Then you pay instrumental payments. Then you do your blocked account of 10,236. But the visa process is 8 months. So take 4 to 8 months, but lean towards more of 8 months. Same thing with masters. You can find masters as low as 12,000 euros. You can pay 2,000. When you get on campus, you pay the rest over time. So that's 2,000 euros. Then when you're about to travel, you need that 10,236, which is your blocked account. So actually, it takes about 8 months to 4 to 8 months. Lean tomorrow's more of 8 months. Now, the good thing about Germany is that it's more affordable. If you know that you want to go from now, you're planning further ahead, then maybe you can take that option for yourself. But nobody's in a hurry to go to, you can't be in a hurry to go to Germany right now because things have a bit changed. The only quickest way to go to Germany is you go through one of the schools that we have in Spain. You start one semester there, then you transfer to Germany. So you remember, if you go back now, like for example now, and the most common programs that have this are about 30,000 euros initially. So you pay 7,006 and above, you do your 12,000 euros bank statement. Then in your second semester, you pay the other school fees to the school in Germany. Then you now do your blocked accounts before you're allowed to come. So you still need to spend money. At the end of the day, you still need to do your blocked accounts. But that's the only way to come to Germany right now. That's the fastest option when it comes to a bachelor's degree or a master's degree. So that's about it. Then, the Ausbildung. Ausbildung program is when you have your German, or you can learn German. Then you get to go and study a vocational course, especially in nursing. We have nursing for now for vocational courses. So that's the only option we have for now. But now, this is very relative because the visa category is quicker. Especially if you have learned the language, then you don't have to wait so long. So let's say on an average person, it takes between 5 to 14 months. Because if you have learned the language, obviously it's faster. If you have not, you have to learn the language half online and you do the rest of our time. Now, the good thing is that there's a way. You don't need a blocked account when you're coming for the Ausbildung. You just have to pay for your German school, which is ranging from 8,000 euros to 10,000 euros. And it depends on the number of installments you pay. That's what will determine the payment. For example, now, if you pay 5,000 euros initially, then you pay the rest of 3,000 later. But if you pay 10,000 euros at once, if you decide that you want to use the 10,000 euros payment, you pay 5,000 first, then maybe you pay 5,000 later. But if you pay everything at once, they will only charge you like 8,000. So they give you a discount or something like that. So 8,000 and above, depending on the school. So that's how it works for it. Now, the student colleague. Student colleague means that you go for, we have some A-level schools, the student colleague, that you can actually go and learn in English. You study in a free school, but you have a foundation in English, like informatics and some other courses. So it's about 9,000 euros. You still need 10,236 euros together. Then that's what's making it about 20,000 euros. But after that, you get to study for free. But the visa process is still, 8 months in total. So just take 4 to 8 months like other things. Then doctorate in business is about, we only have a doctorate in business, no PhD, and that's in Germany. The school fees is about 12,500 euros per annum. Then you can pay 2,000 when you get on campus, you pay the rest of our time. Then you now need 10,236 so as your blocked account, but the visa process is like 4 months. So lean towards more of 4 months because you fall into a special category with this. So these are your options. Yeah, you have to, sometimes I went fast, sometimes I went slow. You have to just rewind, do you understand, when it comes to this. And post-study visa for Germany is 18 months, Spain is one year, Denmark is 6 months. Then Spain is 1 year. Yeah, that's basically it. So I'm looking if I missed anything with regards to your finance. I think this is the general idea. Always when I say initial deposit to get there, then you now add your living expense proof. Or if the country doesn't have living expense proof, you have to add. So take your time, look at these figures, discuss it with your sponsor. Make sure it's something that you know is something you can go for. Then when you're really interested in a particular one, you're gonna say, okay, based on what I said, you want more information. You have the general overview of what you need to spend. Do you understand? So if you have the initial deposit, you can always go with that one. Then when you get on campus, you pay the rest over time. I look forward to us having a conversation. AOC or nothing.